Cousins and Cousins. June 1st. Today is Motherfuckers and Hillbillies, only June 1st. Skinner Bears, Richard Bowler, was Barbara Castle, and she goes on to say the former vocalist Tony Renault Tuckle, who was the front of the schedule at the time, because he was kind of like the AML guy. He said that Rich Bowen and Selen Tony Renault basically personally was a really bad match, because from what I get, for a band like Skid Row, who's been around ever since the Spostenbach was fired, this is like 95-96, so they went through like so many more from that. I take Skid Row to the next level, but when I told him the rules, speaking for me, for experience, he didn't, to me, really fit the bill. I don't know if what you did since June 2nd, 4th, or going on with the number of stockholders, some of them was built at this location where I'm going on with most electric consoles was a kiss visit, so I'm seeing like this is like now 14 years later, I'm having a chance. I don't know if it's Opus, or June 2nd, of course, where Rock Wrestle, Gopher Park, and the Netherlands, over the spec that's been March 2019 booking material for Spawn 2016, Sorceress, the 2019 release. Shout out and congrats on order to the legendary Black Sabbath drummer Bill Ward. Recognition of Rock 15 was the third of 3 months celebrations of the 7th birthday, which highlights the promo. To me, if you think of Queen's Paris all the time, which I'll get down a lot, but Bill Ward, he's like up there. That's probably the first time someone to rock on the Rage Festival Clubs, a whole base to make Crash Book with Harder Lucas. He's on the decision of the tour, Summer Prophets of Rage, I think it was. There's the tour, Summer Prophets of Rage. I think it was actually just kind of mentioned with Tony Ellis and booking, which is like we're doing something bigger to summer and try to find a band. Oh, we have a tour of big fans of Radiance, which is an awesome share stage. He's got a really fun experience. Although, the big production translated atmosphere says that it's pretty much how the big revival we're going to have this atmosphere. We're still staging. And the staging is a little different. We have idea of definitely on the end of the bands. What is the bar to house that it's kick or going to see my favorite punk bands going through their town, which is really fun. And I reflect so far in the band is kind of a trip. My last time we were just going off to our entire stadium in a town, that's like a dream come true right there. Things like that, things like activism and stuff, things were enjoyable. It goes on to say that Avenged Sevenfold is not the biggest band yet. Well, some people have their thoughts. You know, Avenged Sevenfold is like up there. The reason on the stage was a surprise release that came out last summer. That to me was kind of like, well, doing me. You all seem to block my opportunity. For a lot of current dead days, vocals, John Crow was impact metal channel the whole concert. He talks about the lyrics of the dead days song Resurrected. I think that a lot of people kind of like see a lot of styles, because Europe is all set up in the world with all the events that came out, because Corinne, who created this dude, John Corabi, was the frontman of all that crew years before Ben Steel took over. Because he was a keyboard designer, and I said, if you go for a little call, accent, whole country, he goes on and says, there's a single, there's no solo record, and rock really easy. He said, the title sounds like being professional, which is all of his works. Prior books, Uncle's Brothers, a rock on a vessel, Tire, Billy, who else, what care, buckle, so. Oklahoma City, Real Estate, Wall, 1.5. It goes on to say there's a lot of density on the moving up of the elephant, which you haven't heard the record. It's, you know, somebody will say, is it Gacy Elephant's best work? Well, to me it is, but I definitely think Gacy Elephant's E.T. Elephant album, to me personally, I think it was long overdue. Part of Volbeat's May 29th performance, Serious Hour, Dictator's Michael Postle, Volbeat, Book of Heavy TV, folks, and Kodesh.com, says old school death metal side protocol materialized eventually. He's working on some kind of old school death metal.